apologies there real quick. I know before we got to the rooftop scene, I know that for a split second there I like skipped one of the texts like really fast. I just want to apologize for that. But the reason why I skipped the text there real quick is because like I was just in mid thought on what to think about next before we got into the next battle, and I was thinking about like how when I was in middle school, how like I got into YouTube and like watching Let's Players and everything. Like when I started watching Let's Players and, you know, being inspired by, you know, Winslet 13 at the time when I was watching it. Like I never did YouTube back then, but I did watch a lot of Let's Players, and like a lot of Let's Players that I watched, you know, they played a lot of like anime games or a lot of weeb games or what people were called it, but they played a lot of anime games. But funny enough, not a lot of them stay up on YouTube. Like when I was in middle school, I think it was 2006 and 2007 I was in middle school, but it's just like not a lot of them stayed up from the Let's Players that I watched. I remember there was one Let's Player that did a Let's Play of Cowboy Bebop, which I plan on doing on my channel soon, but he did a Let's Play of Cowboy Bebop on the PS2, and it was amazing. Like, he had a lot of views, people were loving it and everything, because people didn't know a Cowboy Bebop game existed, but he only did, like, one, one part of that Let's Play, and that was it. And I was like, man, if I had a Japanese, and he did own an actual Japanese PS2, he didn't take out the laser disc or anything, and I was like, if I own a Japanese PS2, I'd be playing that game for hours and do a bunch of videos on it. But it's just, you know, I guess when you have other things going for you and everything, you can't just be sitting and doing Let's Plays all the time, which is understandable, especially nowadays on YouTube, where it's just like, you know, back in 2006 and 2008 with YouTube's old layout, where you used to get like, you know, little, it's not really rewards, it's more, I'm not sure what you call them, I'm just gonna call them rewards just for right now, but you used to get rewards on your channel, and it used to like pop up on your YouTube channel, but like had most subscribed, like the fastest amount of subscribers on YouTube, and like I said, it's the, like the really old YouTube layout back in the day. But now, you know, you don't really get that anymore. You kind of get like a gold, silver, like YouTube play button, stuff like that. But back in the day, you had like a star on like the fastest subscriber, the fastest growing channel on YouTube back then. And you know, it's a lot different. And you know, I can understand that like doing Let's Plays and everything is, you know, not the same. And you kind of have to step up and everything. I just died there. Crap. It's all right. It gives me the chance to talk more, and people are probably like, oh, he's talking more. I just wanted to have the Let's Play over with. But, yeah, I have seen a lot of Let's Players. I have been on YouTube for, like, a really long time and everything, seen the layouts and Let's Players and everything. And, like I said, it's crazy how I looked up to people doing YouTube and everything, and now I do it myself. And I don't plan on, like, being an inspiration or have people look up to me. I just plan on people to enjoy my stuff and be relatable in a sense. Like, you know, I like anime stuff, I like weeb stuff, and you know, if you stumble across this video, rather if you know if it gets uploaded by the time, you know, the video gets actually uploaded, or if you stumble across this video years along the line, you know, leave a comment. Like, what's your favorite anime? Did you stumble across any animes towards YouTube? Like, I don't want to be like a role model. I don't want to be inspiration. I just want to be relatable to people, because at the end of the day, this is kind of, and I'm gonna delve like into my personal life and everything, but this is kind of the problem I had with my anime club in my high school. Freshman and sophomore year, the problem with my anime club was they thought that they were bigger than everybody. Like, all the people that come to the club and everything, you're below us and everything. If we run this anime club, the thing is, it was just like, we're all losers in a sense, but you're the biggest loser if you plan on like looking down upon us and everything. And I'm not trying to show, you know, throw shade at anybody or anything, but it's just like, you know, we all have the same passion and love the same thing. Just because you guys are a leader of a group doesn't really mean anything. And, you know, just because you guys are leaders doesn't mean anything. It's the, you know, fans, you know, people that come to your stuff is what make you. And like, a lot of people forget that, like even on YouTube, like people forget that viewers and people that watch their stuff, they're the ones that end up making them. Sure, they make the content, but the views and the support and everything comes from fans. And that's what and going back to the when I used to go to anime club and everything, that was the problem, where it's just like, you know, like, yeah, we were losers, the ones that went to anime club, but they were the bigger losers thinking that they were above us and everything. And by the way, when I mean anime club leaders, I know some of my friends are gonna watch this. Samantha, I'm not talking about you, I'm talking about the people that came before you and everything. But besides from that, this, yeah, just like I said before, it's just like they felt that they had, you know, the authority, you know, over us and everything. They felt like they were our boss or like some overpowered being or whatever. And it's just like, you know, it don't work like that. Like, we're all losers in a sense, and we all like the same thing. How about, you know, like, you can't really expect each other. Like, that's going too far to ask people that. And I know I usually stay quiet during the cutscenes, but I'm going to throw that out for this part. But it's just like, you know, we all have the same passion and we all like the same thing. So why not really not really get along with each other, but kind of disagree with each other and share our thoughts on what we like? And it didn't really work like that in my anime high school. And from what it seems like, a lot of anime high schools don't work like that. I didn't mean anime high school as my high school was anime, I meant anime clubs. But a lot of anime clubs, you know, don't really work like that. It's just like, oh, I'm the leader of an anime club, that means I can boss these people? Like, no, it doesn't work like that. Because eventually, the people, like, you have to have members in order to run a club. That's the thing. If you don't have members or people, like, going there, then you're nothing. You're nobody at the end of the day. And we're all nobodies and nothing. But if we all like the same stuff, then we can relate. We can, you know, be friends and, not even probably be friends, but, you know, we can relate to each other and probably share the same laughs, you know what I'm saying? And I know I'm rambling and everything, and I usually stay quiet during these cutscenes, but it's just, that anime club experiencing this really made me realize that, like, to give someone power or authority or just to have them abuse somebody or look over someone, then they'll really take that to heart, depending on what kind of person they are. And it's just like, you know, at the end of the day, like, when it comes to anime or anything, like, we're all losers, we're all geeks, especially with the anime club and anime community, we're all weeaboos, we're no better than anybody. But if anything, we should really just accept people that like the same thing as us and just have fun with it. You know, we don't have to be friends, or we don't have to really, if anything, get along with each other. But, you know, we do like the same thing, so why not have fun with it, and why not have fun with other people with it? But I rambled on too long about that. I've got, like, all serious and everything, but this is what this series is for. Like, this is why I wanted to do this, like, let's play episode series, just, you know, get myself involved with, you know, whoever stumbles across it. And, you know, rather if they share the same ideas or opinions or thoughts as me, it's really all right. Like, I mean, it involves around anime, if anything, you know. If I'm going to talk about anime, I'd rather have other people talk about anime with me, rather be in the comments or wherever it comes from. And I know I'm skipping this a lot, and I don't want you to hear the volume from my TV, but it's just, that's what I kind of did this series for. Not only just for ikki tousen, but whatever let's play I come across, is to talk about anime and experience I've had in life. And recently on YouTube, on my channel, I'm kind of just a guy that kind of flip-flops between projects and everything. But in actuality, you know, person, you know, experience life and, you know, people and everything else. And, you know, if you like anime, if you had the experience for yourself, then, you know, stay tuned. There's, you know, much more stuff to go around, and especially me to go around, since it's, you know, that I run the channel and everything. But, you know, stay tuned and everything, and there's a lot more stuff, a lot more topics, discussions, even with the Let's Play stuff. Like, I just go on somewhat tangents and experience on what I've experienced in life. But if anything, if you like anime, if you're a weeaboo, doesn't matter, you know, welcome aboard, basically, you know. It's all accepted and everything, and anything anime related, it's welcome in my books. Anything anime related, you know, English, I like anything anime related, doesn't matter. But besides from that, I think I rambled on long enough. Let's get on to this cutscene. I apologize for rambling, but let's see the rest of this cutscene, how it goes.
For Adult Swim.
Hey, what can I tell you? It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. Truthfully, I don't think about those guys much since all that stuff went down.
I got this one nailed.
Take your best shot, kid.
She's out somewhere screwing up and getting in trouble.
Men are such total idiots.
I'm really not up for this.
There's nothing in this world to believe in.
You know what they say, cowboy. Easy come, easy go.
My power is the only power.
Take him out and do it quick!
I was watching a bad dream I never woke up from. Your partner's in deep trouble. Let's just say my past is catching up to me. The people who go against the sea lose.
Well, it's a small fry.
Sometimes it ain't pretty, but it's a living.